Good afternoon, you two. Welcome to The Truth According to Lily. I am your host, Lily. And today on Back My Unpopular Demand, I'm super sleepy. I just filmed my Star Trek Picard video. Still really sleepy, but I don't want to take a nap because, like I said in that video, if I take a nap, I'm gonna wake up with a killer headache, and I don't want that. You don't want that for me, right? You would much rather be watching this. So the season finale of Star Trek Discovery Season 4 came out on Thursday, and I've got some thoughts. I stopped reviewing it episode to episode. Honestly, I just got too busy and I didn't feel like being on camera and all that other shit. But I do want to discuss the remainder of the season. Now you can choose to agree or disagree with me if you want on what I'm about to say next. But I have noticed a trend that after Discovery comes back from its mid-season break, it tends to suffer. Like, the remainder of the season tends to suffer, and each season has suffered in different ways. Discovery doesn't always have the best finales, and I'm not saying that they're bad, but they're not always the best. And it's hard to have a satisfying finale, so like, I'm not faulting them or anything like that. But like, it was like the Red Angel thing. I was just kind of like, I hated that whole plot line. I really, really did. I feel like you could have included Pike and Spock in season 2 of Discovery and not had the Red Angel plot at all. I thought it was totally useless. I felt like it added nothing to the whole overarching story, and it was just kind of boring to me, honestly. However, with that being said, everything with Control I actually really liked. But I think I did. And rewatching it, I liked it. And then season 3, you're building up what has happened to the Federation post the burn and 400 years or whatever, however long it is that they went into the future. So you have that, you're building that new world, essentially. You're building a futuristic Star Trek world that we haven't seen before. So there's gonna be conflict, there's gonna be drama, and all that other stuff. I just didn't like the explanation for the burn. I thought the explanation for the burn was quite frankly stupid. I didn't like it. I didn't have any problem with them including more Kelpians. I want to go back to Kaminar. I like Kaminar. Looks pretty chill now that, you know, the Ba'ul aren't killing everyone. I just didn't like the explanation for it, that some kid just threw a temper tantrum and then blew up all of the ships. I was like, okay, sure, it's Star Trek. And then with season 4, I actually really liked the finale. The finale had a lot of hope. The finale had a lot of diversity. The finale had a lot of things that I was just really here for. And I didn't hate it. I thought this was a fair, and I thought it was a fairly thorough finale. I mean, we still have some. They didn't tie off anything with Kovich and Bryce, who went off and did their own little thing. I feel like they're doing that on purpose. You have to leave people wanting, you know, more. And I liked the first contact, you know, scenario. I liked that this is taking time, that this is also confusing. It's frustrating at times. You know, it's not moving as fast as some people would really like it to. With that being said, I thought there was a lot of really bad character choices, that the writers took certain characters in and I didn't care for it. I hated Book. I don't think he should have gotten off as with that much leniency. He broke so many Federation laws. He endangered all of the billions of people he was trying to save. He was also endangering them at the same time. Tarka used him and used his grief against him. And this whole boo-hoo, I want to find my boyfriend in this alternate timeline, I was just like, you're an asshole. You're an asshole who is too smart for his own good. And you're literally just letting yourself be blind by it. Like, it really bugged the shit out of me. And I hated that Ndoye and Book and Targa are having these super secret conversations in an open corridor where everyone can hear you or see you or could walk in on you. Like, why don't you just go to your private quarters? Like, why don't you just go to an empty room? Like, it was really stupid. Like, it bugged me so much. And normally when characters in movies or TV shows do something like this, like talking in an open area where anyone could walk in on you, like, there's a lot of people on Discovery except in these one corridor. It's like, what is it, off limits or something? Is it constantly being renovated? Is it being cleaned? I don't fucking know. I don't fucking care. But it was stupid. Movies and TV shows have a moment like this, someone is going to overhear the person. Eventually, another character will overhear the person who's gonna be betraying everyone, and then they go and tell someone else who's important, another more important character. But that never happened, so I don't know why you're talking in an open corridor. But Ndoye had a really good, you know, redemption arc, you know, fairly good. Stacey Abrams showed up as the president of Earth, which I was just like, mm-hmm. I was just like, okay. Yep, Stacey Abrams showed up as the president of Earth. I was just like, okay, I'm here for it. Apparently, it really pissed off Ted Cruz. It's like, Ted, do you even watch Star Trek? Go blow me. Like, go away, Ted. Ugh, can we snap him out of existence? Like, snap him to, like, Kronos. Let him hang out with the Klingons for a little bit. No, snap him to Andoria because it's cold. Are you mad, Ted, because they didn't ask you? I guess people are mad about it. I don't give a fuck, honestly. Invite whoever you want. We had Stephen Hawking on Star Trek. Other people, you know, we've had astronauts on Star Trek. If you want to invite Stacey Abrams to come do a cameo and be the president of Earth, be my guest. I ain't got no problem with it. I don't know why everyone else is bitching and moaning about it. Like, the fact that people still got pissed about Sonequa Martin-Green changing her hair is still just, like, absolutely mind-boggling to me. Absolutely mind-boggling. But yeah, I thought the finale was better than previous finales. I really hope, though, in season 5 there isn't some end-of-the-world scenario. I would like there to be, like, an end-of-the-world scenario for somebody else. I mean, I guess technically this was, because the DMA could literally destroy any planet, and Book's world did end. I don't want an end-of-the-world scenario for anybody. I would like something a little bit more down-to-earth. Something like, give me a bad admiral. Like, I'd like a bad admiral one. Like a bad admiral. That'd be good. I'd like something like that. President Rilik? Relic? I can't really remember. President Rilik. I think it's Rilik. But I feel like somebody else has also been called Rilik. Whatever. It doesn't matter. The president of the Federation, I thought was great from start to finish. I think she learned a lot. I think Michael learned a lot from her. And it shows, like, once again, I feel like I said this at the beginning of the season, like, Michael still has a lot to learn. You know, she's only been a captain for like a year at this point. And before that, she was wandering around the galaxy by herself the majority of the time. You know what I mean? And before that, she was still technically a mutineer. And before that, she was a mutineer. So Michael still got a lot left to learn. And I like that she acknowledges that she did learn a lot from the president. I think that's pretty cool. Again, President Rilik is my favorite politician. I have no issues with her. I thought she was cool. But yeah, Book woke up from his mission with Tarka way too late, in my opinion, and it just pissed me off. I thought they became idiots and were just like, dude, just fucking shit up and being dumb about it. Like, they weren't even trying. Like, they weren't helping anyone. Nothing was being helped by anything that they did, and I really hope Tarka just blew up. I feel like he did. Did we see Tarka die? I don't really remember. I kind of just remember him holding his transport device and then we cut away. But I don't really remember what else happened. Maybe I was just like happy he was like gonna blow up because he fucking sucked. So all in all, I thought it was a pretty good finale. I am looking forward to season 5. I'm looking forward to Strange New Worlds. I'm looking forward to more Picard. I'm a happy Star Trek fan right now, you know? Just because I had some things to criticize about it doesn't mean I'm not going to go back and continue watching. Like, trust me, I have plenty of things to criticize Next Gen about, DS9. Well, actually, the least of which is probably DS9, honestly. Voyager. Just because Discovery is new doesn't mean that it doesn't get to be criticized. They have made some mistakes. I acknowledge those mistakes. And I still come back and I watch it because I really do enjoy it. I thought Michael was the best she has ever been in this season. I thought she was fantastic. I feel like she did let herself get emotionally compromised one too many times. But, you know, these are extraordinary circumstances. It's bound to happen. And when someone points it out to her, she puts herself in check. So I feel like Michael was the most mature she's ever been. She was the best leader she could have been. I was thoroughly proud of her as a character. Everything with Michael, I thought, was fantastic in this season. Even after the mid-season finale. Everything after the mid-season finale, everything with Book and Tarka was what pissed me off the most. I just couldn't keep finding it within myself to feel bad for Book anymore. I really, really couldn't. And the fact that he went through something so terrible and traumatic and the writers forced me to hate him, I feel like says a lot. So, oh yeah, he's like in exile basically, but he gets to help refugees. Like, that's what he's doing right now. So that's like his punishment. I don't think being sent to help refugees should be seen as a punishment. That's just me though. I feel like you should at least go into a penal colony for like 10 years. I feel like what Tom Paris went to a penal colony for was probably way less. Actually, let's find that out just so I don't, he could have killed someone for all I know. Bombing an alien world, oh. During Voyager's 3rd and 4th seasons, Enders German. Oh no, this is like, that's not what I'm talking about. Oh, okay, so I got it right this time. So, tried and convicted of treason for aiding the Maquis Rebellion, Paris was sentenced to serve time in a Federation penal settlement near Auckland, New Zealand. Okay, so like, Tom Paris aided the Maquis and got sent to a penal colony. Book interfered with First Contact and could have started a war, and he gets to go do volunteer work. I'm just saying. So yeah, super proud of Michael. It was nice seeing Tilia back again. I like that she stayed with the Admiral on like that ship thing that looks like a weird light bulb. I'm glad that she stayed with him. I thought that was like super mature of her and really brave. And yeah, I liked the season, you know, whatever criticisms I have of it, it doesn't stop me from enjoying it and liking it. It's okay to criticize things. It's okay for the writers to get it wrong sometimes, and it's okay for them, and it's even more than okay for them to get it right so I can continue to enjoy new Star Trek. With all that being said, that's how I felt about the last of Star Trek Discovery season 4. And I'm looking forward to more. You know, they've already started filming season 5. Actually, I don't know if they've actually started filming or if they've wrapped filming. I'm not 100% sure. But either way, I'm excited, and I continue to be excited about all of this. So thank you for watching. Live long and prosper. Peace and long life. And stay tuned and turned on for more.